Bisbal has been KO'd before in the second round. Apply pressure and land your left hand at your power.
There's Victor Bisbal, 32-year-old, came in at 245 pounds. He's 6'4", 21-1, a two-time Russian amateur heavyweight national titleist is Abdusalamov. Now we've seen him.
Number one, defend yourselves at all times. Now shake hands and come out of the bell. Shake hands.
Jamil McClain, the most recent opponent for Mago Abdusalamov, former title challenger.
It's graphic, but I'll tell you, Bisbal looks soft around the body, the midsection, over 5 years. Bisbal's hope is to box a little bit, stay on the outside, not get too close to the physically. Abdusalamov was on the floor in his last fight to a 42-year-old former contender.
Went down in the first round of that fight against Jamil McClain.
Two fights in 2012. Abdusalamov, last time he was in the ring 6 months ago, I start to say, hey, considering his career, to me, he should be fighting even more often. But not always easy to find opponents who build up that record and the opponents that are considered safe. Well, guess what? They want to get paid if they're going to get
missed of round one. Two times he sent Abdusalamov taking a back step with a right hand to that body. That soft body, as Teddy pointed out, Bisbal coming in at 245 pounds.
His only loss was by knockout loss. That means he can be put to sleep, and that's what Abdusalamov. One of the good things, never discount that. 2004 Olympic representative.
You know, those guys on the Puerto Rican national team are always well tested prior to turning pro. So glad to have you with us here.
In the three losses in Kyle's career, he's been knocked out all three times. I don't think it's his chin. I think he gets worse in here for me. Can Taylor be an aggressive, physical fighter tonight? In other words, can he go to the basket, get in the paint, and dunk a few? We're gonna find out. Fight.
Does he fall in line with the sport? Marcus Maidana, Lamont Peterson, Nate Campbell. Those the three losses of Victor Kaya. Round number two here of our rep.
You know, I think sometimes I look. Sometimes I look and I see a ticking time bomb. Now, a lot of people would think that what I'm obviously gonna roll up and knock somebody out at any time
right,
he gets
right,
to the ring.
Punch,
to me, he might implode. He might blow up himself. Soon as the guy doesn't cooperate, where he can't hit him on the chin, he doesn't disappear. Because he's gotten his way so much that I don't know if it spits back at him.
Yeah, somebody just can't push around and have his way with. And Bisbal, with the right hand that we've seen glimpses of so far tonight, is trying to be there. Mago comes falling in that time. It's a right hand from Bisbal. Right hook from Mago.
The only thing he's got to be careful of, Bisbal, is that he don't get caught up. Abdusalamov starting to expose him a little bit. Some of his shortcomings, he's right in front of you, he's not hard to find, but he can still pump. You know, get a few punches off, catch him like you did. Don't get carried away with your own success. Remind yourself, you still got a dangerous
guy. Heavyweight fight, but first we say hello to Todd Grisham. Good evening, Todd. Forward to hearing what Teddy has to say about the 48-year-old Bernard Hopkins taking on the undefeated from Teddy. And Todd joins us for the studio portion of Friday, showing you the total punches so far. Bisbal has been the busier man and also outlanding Abdusalamov. 48-26 advantage, according to CompuBox, as we begin round number three.
You know, speaking of senior citizens, which Todd was with Hopkins, both these in front of us have been picking on the seniors a little bit. Both won versus senior last fight. Abdusalamov versus a 41-year-old, actually a 42-year-old, and Bisbal versus a 38-year-old in his last fight. And so I guess what I'm saying is both guys are vulnerable to good opposition. And
it's forward with a straight left hand that was blocked away by Bisbal.
Right now, they've been done that a couple times. Bisbal, it's his fight to win, but it's also his fight to lose. Advantage, but he can't stay in the pocket, even though he's having success. Can't stay there and get greedy. I like to walk around him a little bit. Don't stay there, that extra beat.
Let him out, let him out.
Yes, some of this. But I agree with you, Teddy. I just like the way he's moving his hands and his disposition of always firing after.
Well, Abdusalamov has been getting set up for a loss since he turned pro. Well, what do I mean by that? He's been put in there with a lot of stuff. Still a long way to go.
Reminder that you can score along with Teddy at the Friday Night Fight Facebook page and click on the live scoring application and judge each round. Can jump in at any point.
Bisbal standing in front of Abdusalamov this round, much too much, I think, and allowing Abdusalamov to have his best round.
We'll take a quick break and be right back to Atlantic City. In Atlantic City, and a good way to open up Friday night, with 16 knockouts is Abdusalamov.
Well, more interesting, but how will Abdusalamov start to behave if he gets this round?
Only the first time in the career of the unbeaten Abdusalamov today scored a fourth round TKO against Jason Pettaway.
You know, I would like fight a Bisbal question. I'd be saying, how's he going to behave if you're still standing there after this question form? Yes, he's going to have doubts. Don't give them to him.
Puerto Rican.
More legs this round, so we'll keep the stronger, better punching Abdusalamov at bay, off balance.
We trade uppercuts.
A little headbutt there. Bisbal, for the most part, wants to do it on the top.
Oh, boy.
Stay away from that power, and right there, he didn't stay away from it.
He got Teddy.
But he reacted. He handled it. He came back pretty good. See, that's what I'm looking for. Stay on the outside. Look for spots for the right. Use your jab to keep distance. And look for shots or spots for the right hand that usually works against the southpaw.
Left hand from the unbeaten southpaw.
Well, he stepped into range that time after the Sunday punch. The left hand. The punch that the southpaw can turn into. And he goes.
Four of our heavyweight opener here. We'll take a short break, come back, and show you that one good punch there.
Champ, what do we say? Abdusalamov stepping with your left hand, your power punch, and he landed a nice shot. Follow up, Bisbal, and Abdusalamov now is in uncharted, is there for him.
Tying up for a moment. Oh boy!
One, two, three, four, five, six.
Bisbal trying to beat the count. He is unsteady on his feet. And it's Will Salamov. Moves to 17-0 with 17 knockouts.
Punching Abdusalamov just a little bit too many times. And finally, the ultimate price with that left hand.
Back pocket.
We talked about peace. The left hand would do it. Nice straight left hand, the power punch for the lefty. You turn able to pivot that left foot, move that shoulder forward, and get that back. Look in a super slow-mo. I'm sure Bisbal doesn't want to see that, but
super slow-mo.
There's a late punch. Somebody needs to talk to Abdusalamov. Disqualification down the road.
For the official particulars, Bob Alexander.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Superstar Theater at Resort in New Jersey, your referee in charge, Randy Newman, waves off the bout at 1 minute, 12 seconds of the Magomed Abdusalamov.
So he made it to the fifth round this time after that string of all.